Hello, this is Dr. Carlo Oller, emergency physician and founder of edexitvideo.com. This video is about methyl alcohol poisoning. Methanol, or wood alcohol, is a clear, colorless solvent found in antifreeze, cleaning solutions, copy machine fluid, gasoline additives, paint, paint thinner, and liquid fuel. Methanol is less expensive than ethanol and may be used by chronic alcoholics as a substitute. Intoxication also can be secondary to methanol contaminant grain alcohol or moonshine, accidental ingestion, or a suicide attempt. Methanol produces inebriation, and its metabolic products may cause metabolic acidosis, blindness, and even death. Risk factors for methanol poisoning include alcoholism. Epidemics may occur in institutionalized settings where ethyl alcohol is unavailable. Prisons. Inappropriate storage leading to childhood exposure is another risk factor. Classic clinical picture includes nausea, vomiting, abdominal pain, visual disturbance, and metabolic acidosis. There is a latent period after injection of 6 to 24 hours before onset of symptoms. This may be delayed further with concomitant ethanol ingestion. Overt clinical signs are expected with severe exposure, but a low doses, like an occupational exposure, elevated methanol levels may be the only sign. Initial CNS depression or inebriation, followed by headache, vertigo, lethargy, confusion. Severely intoxicated patients can present with coma and convulsions. Visual disturbance, ranging from mild blurring to complete blindness, quote-unquote, like standing in a snowfield. GI symptoms may include nausea, vomiting, and marked abdominal pain. Shortness of breath can also be present. Physical exam findings include inebriation and gastritis, heart rate abnormalities including slow heart rate, tachypnea, which is increased respiratory rate due to the metabolic acidosis, visual field defects like blurred or double vision, loss of visual acuity, or pupillary reaction. Fundoscopic exam may reveal retinal edema hyperemia and loss of disc cupping, abdominal tenderness, stupor, confusion, seizure, or coma may be present. Parkinson-type symptoms have been reported in severe acute and low-level chronic methanol poisoning. Serum methanol may be elevated acutely. After a latent period, serum formaldehyde is a better measure of toxicity. Elevated osmolar gap and anion gap include lactate and ethanol levels to help identify acid contributing to elevated anion gap. Urinalysis may show myoglobinuria. An arterial blood gas, electrolytes, BUN, creatinine, and other tests are also going to be performed. CT scan of the brain or MRI of the brain is done as part of the neurological exam to rule out other problems like a stroke or a bleeding. Brain imaging may reveal optic pathway damage, hypodensities in the putamen or caudate nucleus, cerebral edema, cerebral hemorrhage, or cerebral infarct. Ethanol and fomepizole, orally or IV, competes with methanol for the binding site and effectively treats the methanol poisoning. In severe poisonings, hemodialysis may be necessary. Outcome varies depending on time to presentation and quantity of the methanol ingested. Outcome is related to the degree of acidosis, coma, or seizures at the time of presentation. Diagnosis and treatment delays are correlated with poor outcome. Complications include blindness, renal failure, pancreatitis, and Parkinson's syndrome. Since this is an emergency, you'll most likely be admitted to a hospital. So follow-up after your admission will be arranged by your discharging physician. any significant deterioration or any new symptoms after your discharge, you should come back for re-evaluation. For more videos like this one, please go to edexitvideo.com. And remember, these are educational videos and should never replace the attention or care from a medical provider. Please take a minute to like my video and to subscribe to my channel.